Okay, Satur Ocampo called you a butcher and a liar, and you're calling Satur Ocampo the biggest liar. What makes you say Satur Ocampo deceives people?
Well, he talks something that they are for the people, and yet they really want people to get poorer, so that they could use them, they could recruit them to the NPA, because if the country is getting better, then no one will follow the revolution.
So, but why do you say this of Satur Ocampo? I mean, what's the basis?
Well, he has...
He ran for Congress already. Now he's running for Senator. So why would you say this?
Yeah, because he has not changed. He has not denounced his membership in the NPA. And I believe that he's the commander, overall commander of the NPA, including the political arm of the communists in this country.
So you believe Satur Ocampo is the overall head of the NPA?
And he directs all these operations. He's just like a chief of staff or commander-in-chief in this country of the revolutionary movement.
So you believe he belongs in jail too?
Well, I really believe that he knows a lot about these killings, massacre, and revolutionary taxation. They're the biggest effort is revolutionary taxation.
Now, this is very interesting. What makes you say that Satur Ocampo is the leader of the NPA?
He is the most senior and very active, highest-ranking communist in this country.
Okay. Yeah, but other than that?
Well, other than that, he has been into places, meeting with the NPA.
Okay, okay. And for you, he should be denouncing the NPA?
Yes, he should be denouncing it. He said that... He denounced the acts, but he has not denounced any act of atrocity by the NPA. Mm-hmm. The Taboso massacre, and other massacres. He's been accused of killing or the massacre in Inupakan lately. And he has a lot to explain. As a congressman, he should have a stand on revolutionary taxation as well as the atrocities of the NPA, but he doesn't want. That's a clear indication that he's part of them.
Okay, very interesting. You're the stand on revolutionary tax. What about you? What do you think of that?
Well, that should not be allowed, and we really have to go after these people, you know, with both the collector and the payer.
Okay, now I want to ask you this now. Okay, oh gosh, there's so many questions for you that are coming up here now. Okay, what is your priority if you're elected senator? Bonnie Station asks.
Well, of course, I am, as I said, security and peace and order is our priority. And there are two agencies which we have to help pass laws for them to be capable of doing the job, and that is the Department of National Defense and the Department of Local Government,
okay,
which are involved in insurgency and other peace and order problems in respective areas.
Okay. Now, you told me earlier you believe you have a chance of winning. I mean, given the Pulse Asia survey recently that came out on the top 20, I didn't see your name even on the top 20. Where do you think will you get your votes?
Well, I think the people has not been informed properly. Okay. I think that's our problem, our dissemination, because we lack resources.
Why didn't you run with Lakas? You could have run with Lakas Kampi.
Well, I didn't want to get involved so much in the administration, because they have been accusing me of all the accusations against the administration. So
okay.
I don't want to exacerbate that, you know.
All right. Okay. All right. So that's why you chose to run as independent senator. How much have you spent so far?
Well, so far not much really. Maybe not even 4 million, nothing.
4 million of your own savings?
Savings and some contributions.
Okay, but will you regret that if you lose? I mean, I'm just curious. It's still a lot of money.
Well, it's still a lot of money. But people who contributed are inspiring, and they are willing to support us. That's why they're helping, but they don't have money, so much money. That's why it's not that big.
Okay. Now, well, one of the things you're battling is generally... You know, forgive me for saying this, but a very negative reputation. I mean, people call you these things, benevolent torture.
It's not people. It's just this communist movement.
Okay.
The people are, if you go places where I've been assigned to, people have appreciated our performance there, and they are getting better in their life. That's why they are expressing their gratitude to us and to the soldiers.
But even the AFP, you know, I was reading this, that Inserto himself said that the new and young generation of AFP officers headed by General Alexander Yano do not condone human rights abuses, and they do admit that your style didn't work exactly.
Well, these are what some of the officers who do not understand the problem of insurgency, because Acerto is an Air Force officer and he really knows nothing. I'm sorry to say that, you know.
Okay. Yeah. All right. Well, this is interesting. Chris N73, just to let you know, he feels you were more credible than Saturo Campo, but he says he's not voting for any soldier, more so a communist, in the Senate this election. So I want to ask you this. To our viewers who are watching right now, why should they vote for you? What's your number? 41.
Yeah.
This is 41 candidate. In the Senate.
Yes.
So you are number 41 in the Senate. Why should they vote for you?
Because I want this country to be peaceful, to get better, to develop better, because we have a lot of potential. Mm-hmm. And this is, we are not developing so much, mm-hmm. because we have, the biggest problem is security and peace and order.
But how would your being in the Senate stop communist insurgency? I mean, how would your being there help?
Well, as I said, as a senator, you have a lot of influence. And as I said, I would concentrate to help the DILG and the Department of National Defense. And now there is a problem because the local officials are getting to, illicit relationship with the communists.
Okay.
That's why the DILG, the Department of Local Government, must be looked into. I think we have to pass laws that would penalize local officials getting involved with the New People's Army.
Okay, all right. On that note, thank you very much, General, and good luck to you. Good luck.